Well, after 50 years, Brisbane race caller Wayne Wilson hangs up the binoculars tomorrow. He joins us from the Brecky Creek. Wayne, first of all, how did you get started in such an interesting, fascinating business?
Well, it's a long story. I've always been involved in racing, and I was fascinated as a young boy to hear those booming voices at Ferguson Park in Gladstone, the voices like Vince Curry and Ken Howard and Bert Bryant. And somewhere along the line, I made a decision that I wanted to be involved in this racing industry and the media side of things, and I thought, well, that's a good way to join this wonderful industry as a race broadcaster. So it took me along several steps to Brisbane, and eventually I got into harness racing and galloping here, Bill.
So many wonderful moments, I imagine. Can you nominate a high and a low point?
Yeah, well, there are a couple. Of course, my Melbourne Cup call of 2002, when Media Puzzle was successful for Damien Oliver, and all the emotion that surrounded Damien Oliver, with Damien losing his brother just a week before. That was a career highlight for me. On the lows, well, I did have a day at Eagle Farm where I made a mistake in a photo finish, and it happened to be in a Stradbroke handicap. Whilst we're under human, we're not infallible. You don't like to make mistakes in races. You don't like to make mistakes in Stradbroke handicaps. But that was one that really gutted me at the time. I was devastated by it. So I don't like to dwell on that too much, Bill. I'll talk more about the Media Puzzle Melbourne Cup.
All right, that leads me to the next question. How on earth do you remember all those horses?
Well, it's not as difficult as you think, because I'm seeing them all at the time, and eventually those colours get implanted in the brain. And if you're seeing them on a regular basis, it's just like any other professional job. If you go to a doctor and tell him you've got a sore thumb, he'll diagnose what's wrong with you. The same sort of thing with a race caller. You see the horses out there, you see the colours there, and it all sort of comes together very easily.
Your career the more remarkable because you've had a couple of health scares along the way.
Yes, we have. We've been battling cancer for the last 12 years, but I'm glad to say that we're over the worst of it. We're a couple of lengths in front of it at the moment, to use a racing term, and whilst it might surface again at some stage, right now scans indicate that there is no cancer visible in my body. So, mate, I've been very, very lucky, but I think you've got to remain positive in the battle against cancer, and you've got to be looking at buying time if you can, because they're making new discoveries all of the time.
Wonderful news. Can't think of a better way to finish this. You must have a dream field. Do you think you could call for us the final 10 or 15 seconds of the greatest pretend race of all time?
Yeah, all right, I'll do that. And a couple of the idols that I've had in Brisbane racing, and I'll include my favourite horse, Eyeliner, in it as well. So down past the furlong pole, and Eyeliner's the leader. Rough Habit, Felvalon, and Chief to Be is flying home on the outside. Eyeliner's in front. Rough Habit going at Eyeliner. Eyeliner, Rough Habit, they hit it all. Photo, but Eyeliner's won it. Eyeliner's beaten Rough Habit.
Ah, oh, superb. We're going to miss you. All the best in retirement and good health, Wayne Wilson. Thank you.
Good on you, Bill. Thanks, mate.